Good afternoon. Happy Election Day, everyone. Welcome to Great Day, Connecticut.
Get out the vote. Get yes. out the vote.
Vote your voice.
Yeah, this is like the local elections, which I think sometimes are
They
just,
mean even more.
They mean even more because this is what, you know, you're voting for people who are going to make decisions in your local hometown.
Yeah, like there might be referendums. There's, you know,
there's the mayor.
You know, we're watching carefully the race in New Britain where there's a tough mayoral race. We've got the Stamford race of Bobby Valentine. Will he beat the reps?
And so you're going to be here tonight online?
I'm going to be here, and we'll be streaming. For those of you who really want to know what's going on, we're going to have Doobie McDowell on and Brian Flaherty, and we're going to be, as returns are coming in, from 8 to 10 p.m., you can watch us live on the app.
Excellent. You are the digital anchor.
I am. That is my title.
You are the digital queen.
I am the chief digital anchor.
You are the queen of digital.
Does that get me a crown?
I think it might get you a crown.
Can I get a, what kind of crown does it look like? Like an iPad?
No, if you go to the dentist, they'll give you a crown.
Oh my gosh.
All right, Mariah Carey has declared a Christmas season. At midnight on November 1st, she changed the message. It's not time on her Halloween pumpkins by smashing the knot with a candy cane striped baseball bat.
So people, you know, we're making a joke of not Christmas, you know, so it's not time. She's like, oh yeah, watch this.
Watch this. I'm waiting to say,
look,
oh, it's not time.
Okay.
Look at her.
Boom.
Oh, it's time.
It's time for her.
Boy, she's got a little angry, a little aggression going on there.
Most famous song, of course, All I Want for Christmas is You. I have to say, you put that song on and you're like, yep, it's Christmas.
Christmas
is here.
I have the Sirius XM set. Let me know, please, if the Sirius has gone over, because I'm waiting for the channels to go over to Christmas. Typically, it's about November 3rd, so I'm kind of waiting for tomorrow to see what happens.
Oh, to see what happens? Well, there's a bar in Texas, and they have the reverse. They said they're giving Mariah Carey's mega hit the silent treatment.
Well,
they're not going to play it. They think it's, you know, a lot of people think it's
well,
classic.
Well, not until December 1st. they won't play it until December 1st, and then on December 1st, they will only play it once a day in the bar.
So Mariah, it's on the jukebox. You can't do it.
No, you can't
do it. Even if you pay for it,
it says
it will be skipped.
It will be skipped. There's the note. It's kind of, they call themselves a dive bar, and they're really funny. And Mariah Carey posted herself in armor. She said, this is war. So she declared war on
the bar in Texas.
On the bar in Texas. And I'm surprised they didn't get much. They've done it in years past, but I guess nobody's really picked up on it. And now they've picked up on it. And so a lot of people are saying, look at this. Well, I'm going to listen to the song 1 million times. Okay, good for you.
The one thing that we really know
signed
is
Mark
that,
Zinni.
Yeah.
He
loves that song.
He listens to it in July. And
it's
it is
a great song.
It is a great song.
So one thing we know is you really do have to shop earlier, especially if you're ordering anything online.
Yes.
So this could help you.
Okay.
Oprah's Favorite Things 2021 has just dropped. So she has all of the stuff that we should be buying.
Oprah's Most Expensive Things. Did you see the price points in some of these
things? Well, some of it, though, is not expensive.
Not expensive.
Some of them are like $40. But she does all different ranges.
If it's $40 for a candle, $40 for lipstick. The Uggs coat, I don't think it's too bad at $247.
Yeah, for a nice Ugg coat.
For a nice Ugg coat.
And also, again, these are like nice gifts to give people. So Barefoot Dreams Cozy Chic Hooded Robe. I like that. You just walk around in a cozy robe.
You're not getting
robe.
That from me. It's $158.
Okay. Yeah.
What else we got? Oh.
The geometric hoop earrings. Those are nice. $40
Jay
on Amazon.
Jaylani, is that how you say it? Jaylani Jewels. These people become instant overnight successes.
Well, like her foot nanny olive oil pedicure collection, it's from the woman who actually takes care of Oprah's feet.
Oh, seriously.
So if someone really wants some luxury beauty, it's $119, but you could have the kit that Oprah's feet are taking care of.
Could you imagine having someone just to take care of your feet? I mean, it's in all seriousness. the amount of wealth that is involved in that. Where is my foot woman?
Woman? I don't know. She might just be someone who does her nails and pedicure. She can't like just go into a nail salon if you're Oprah.
That's true. I would if I were Oprah.
Yeah. She's talked about that before, that sometimes she would call and order a pizza and they'd be like, well, who is it? And she'd like, it's Oprah Winfrey, and like, click. So there is some like practicality that maybe you don't go walk into the walk-in nail salon when you're Oprah. I don't know.
That is hysterical. Oh, who is this Oprah? Yeah, goodbye. I would not believe you. Could you imagine though? I would go. I would do, if I were Oprah, I would go into the nail salon and be like, hey, people,
hey,
how are you?
It?
Yeah, it's good. What's going on? All right, Jessica Simpson is celebrating 4 years of sobriety. Good for her. On Monday, the singer, actress, and entrepreneur shared on Instagram a photo of herself from 2017 to mark the big milestone. So she was in a precarious place back in 2017. So
she said, "That person is an unrecognizable version of myself."
It really is.
And she said,
"I
needed
right?
to stop drinking alcohol because it kept my mind and heart circling in the same direction, and I was exhausted." So good for her that.
Good for her.
She. You know, noticed that she needed help, and she is in a much better place. It's also part of a TV project. She is going to, so Amazon, you're going to be able to watch it there, and she has, it's based on her best-selling memoir, Open Book.
Which is great, and you know what? I love when celebrities open up and share about these things. I just think it's fantastic. So good for her, 4 years of sobriety, which is awesome.
So well, I know you didn't see Tiger King 1.
I didn't see it. I'm not going to see Tiger
Baskin
King 2.
Carol Baskin does not want to be part of Tiger King 2, but she is.
Apparently, she didn't want to be part of Tiger King 1. The way she reacted, she's like, Carol Baskin's response about being in number two, no, and lose my number.
So that's she's actually suing because she claims that the footage they have that they've used of her in Tiger King 2 was unauthorized.
Unauthorized.
And that they asked her to participate and she gave an emphatic no.
How do you have a Tiger King 2 without Carol Baskin? That's my question.
Well, I'm sure the producers are saying that.
Right.
But she claims the release that she originally signed for Tiger King 1 does not apply to Tiger King 2, that they've kind of they've overreached here. So she's suing.
She's
probably just giving more attention as to why you want to watch this Tiger King 2.
But how do you have happy days without the Fonz?
Exactly.
You know what I mean? It's like, it's...
Well, they have Joe Exotic, too. I mean, I wonder, and he's been in prison.
He's been in prison. What's it going to be?
I don't know. I'm sure Netflix wants you to watch to figure it out.
I'm too busy watching Swamp Games.
Squid Games.
I went to my therapist yesterday, and I said, "Do I keep watching this?" He's like, "Well, not if it's making you unhappy." And I said, he goes, "But it could be a form of therapy, like to realize that it's not real,
no,
that these are characters."
Sometimes you just don't do things that upset you.
Yes, and that's what he said. He says, "If it's really upsetting to you, don't do it. But it could be cathartic therapy to get through it and say, hey, this is just someone's imagination made up in someone's mind and that this is not a real thing." But, you know.
What are you going to do?
I'm probably going to watch the rest of it.
Okay.
I'll let you know.
Okay.
With you.
Do you
with
need a little
you,
help?
No, I don't know if I'm going to watch the rest of it. I'm on episode 2.
Can I make a little plug for something uplifting and,
sure,
and important
absolutely.
To watch?
Impeachment.
So I just found out, if you remember a long time ago, I did a documentary with the World War II Foundation on my dad's escape from Nazi territory when he was shot down
absolutely.
During World War II. So all these people have been emailing me saying how much they love the movie. I'm like, where are you seeing it right now? It's on Amazon Prime. So if you have Amazon Prime, please search for Above and Beyond. It's the story of Bruce Sundland's escape during World War II.
That's fantastic.
You can watch it on Amazon Prime.
I'm
the narrator. I went and I retraced his steps and I met the people who helped save him.
You gave me the CD. You gave me the DVD.
But you can watch it again now.
Yeah,
we can have
great.
A binge
uplifting.
Watch party.
Good.
All right. So.
All right. New Zealanders have voted to choose the country's annual bird of the year. But this year, it's a bat, which I think is a bird.
It's a big bat.
It's a big bat.
Oh, my gosh. Well, he's so ugly, he's cute, right?
Right. He's so ugly. But isn't that... they're saying it's not a bird at all. They're saying it's a bat.
It's a Pekapikatura turoa. I don't know.
Thank you very much.
It's known as a long-tailed bat.
This is the first time the bat or indeed any non-bird... So I guess a bat is not a bird.
A bat is
it's
a mammal.
One. But they're trying to bring attention to it because, as we know, bats are becoming endangered, and we need bats because they take care of the mosquito.
They take care of the insects
and the whole nine yards.
This guy's furry.
He is a little furry.
I wouldn't
furry.
Want to see him hanging upside down in my house.
No, I certainly would not.
Okay.
Not at all.
All right, so you might have a lot of room on your plane if you want to do it. It's not a Peloton bike, but Peloton is partnering with Delta Airlines.
That's the image that I had in my mind. You walk into the plane, and instead of seats, there's Peloton bikes.
That's what I started when I read this. I'm like, Peloton? Delta Airlines? No, they're moving and stretching mid-flight. They're going to help you. They're going to offer all these different stretches, meditation classes to help you kind of relax, fall asleep, and it'll be part of your in-flight entertainment.
So you have to have a screen on the back of your seat in order to watch
and no
this.
One can have their hair hanging
and
over
no
the
one can
screen.
Have their hair hanging over the screen, especially if they're in first class. So again, I guess that's Delta Airlines. They're going to have Peloton, which is pretty cool. I don't know if your neighbor would like that, particularly if you were just jumping up and down and exercising. I think it's more
cathartic. Well, it's also meditation and stretching.
I can just imagine somebody sitting next to you and you convincing them to try a Kara's Cure. The woman next to me is nuts.
All right, listen, the next story. Some of us need to calm down on a flight. It's good for you.
The next story is the best. It stinks. Kara, what's happening?
The toilet, it's not going to be able to be fixed on the SpaceX capsule.
So what are they going to do?
The astronauts are just going to wear diapers. That's it. They got to come back to Earth, and they can't fix it. So they'll be wearing, there'll be special NASA undergarments that are extra enforced or whatever, but they're going to just have to wear the undergarments.
You take a poop and a diaper,
it's a poop and a diaper.
That's what that is.
Maybe they're not going to do number two.
And do you, like we were discussing this in our morning meeting, do you excuse yourself to poop in your diaper, or do you poop right next to somebody?
I really don't know that people want to think about this right now.
This is terrible. It's the conundrum that this is causing.
They have to come back to Earth.
I don't understand why they sent the thing back up with a broken toilet.
They were going to fix it.
It just didn't work.
It didn't work. We've sent everybody to space. It's time to send plumbers now.
I guess it all depends. No pun intended.
All right. We need to switch gears. For all the latest celebrity news, you can watch People the Show right here on Channel 3 at 7:30.
All right. Jeremy, what do you think about the SpaceX toilets? Talk to us, Jeremy.
Tonight on People, I'm with country superstars Lady A, who are getting ready for next week's Country Music Awards, where the group is nominated once again for Vocal Group of the Year.
Congratulations. CMA's coming up. Vocal Group of the Year nomination. How much does that mean to you?
It means so much. I mean... One of the things that we've always talked about is just having longevity as a band and being together for 15 years now, to be included in the category is really special.
Is it one of those things, I mean, you're not unfamiliar with awards. You guys have had such an incredible career up to this point. How does that feeling change as it continues to happen phase after phase, album after album?
Well, I think, like she said, I mean, honestly, gosh, just to have come this far and still be in this kind of part of that group, you know, these newer artists, that's what these moments are, I believe, meant for, is to really expose fans to this new crop of artists. So I'm always looking to, like, you know, the Carly Pierces of the world and Jimmy Allen and all these new artists that are looking to have a little FaceTime and breaking through.
I've been at the CMA Awards a couple times. It just feels like a group hang.
We also discussed last year's name change and the group's latest album, What a Song Can Do. It's all tonight on People.
You know what time that show is going to be on? It's a quarter after one. I'm all alone and I need you now.
That was good.
Thank you.
That was good.